Welcome back, Nintendo collectors. Alex here with another video. Just want to wish you a happy new year for 2016. Hope you had a good holiday, guys. But let's just get straight back into what we do best, and that's collecting and playing Nintendo video games. And I've got a cracker here for you today. It's quite a rare game, actually. It's a game I've wanted in my collection for quite a while, ever since I've owned this Nintendo Red Tent that you see in front of me here. This is a Versus Dual System by Nintendo. There's a game they brought out called Balloon Fight in 1984. You probably got it on the NES, but the NES version didn't come out until 1986. So this came out first. It's an awesome little game. It actually is a lot different than the NES version. And that's why I want to do a video of this game today. Maybe a comparison video. We'll compare it with the NES version. Because it is a really, really cool game. And it makes full use of this dual system here, with the two screens. But before we get onto that, guys, let's start off the video, as always, with pickups and what I've been playing. Haven't had that much time off over Christmas, guys, but have managed to play a few games in the evening. Being self-employed, I have to get straight back to work. Unfortunately, fund this expensive hobby that we like collecting, Nintendo games, so money has to come from somewhere. And I haven't had much time to get a video out either. I really wanted to get the Space Firebird video out. And there's a couple of you guys restoring them at the moment, and I just wanted to get it finished. It wasn't that far away from finishing, but unfortunately the glass didn't fit. I had some glass fitted to go over the top. That didn't fit. Probably my fault, but that's another story. And the soundboard doesn't work, so there's no sound playing out the game. So I just thought, oh, I don't want to put a video out yet. I just want it all working, all finished with the clips on, the glass on. And it's just not quite there, so maybe for another time, if you could just be a bit patient on that. But I do have a really cracking video for you today, and it's obviously, I'll show you that a bit later. But first off, let's just have a look at the games that I've been playing, and some of the few little pickups that I've got. Now, the first game I've got is fairly newish, not that retro, really. And I don't know about you guys, you know, when you haven't had that many new games and you've got such a big library like I have, it's nice to go back into the library, delve in the library and pick up a few games that you didn't have time for back in the day when they came out, or you know, you're distracted in one way or another. So it's nice to go back, pick a game up, you know, it's been sitting in your library for a while without having been played. So this game I picked up was Kid Icarus Uprising for the 3DS. Now I know this is a game that's in a lot of people's top 10 3DS games of all time, so I thought, yeah, I've got to pick this up, man. It comes from lovely box art. It comes with the augmented reality cards, which I haven't used, and a little card holder. But it's a lovely box package, some nice box art, and some screenshots on the back. And it's a really good game, really fun game, really enjoy playing. It's kind of like an on-rail shooter. Bit like Lyat Wars, remember Lyat Wars and Star Fox? Plays very similar to that. So you've got a camera that pushes you around, really. I mean, it's quite linear in that sense that you have to follow the camera. But it's a really cool game, really fast paced, lush graphics. But I had a real problem, you know, a couple of hours into the game, I started getting pins and needles in my hand. And it's because of the way you have to play the game with the stylus. Now I've got the big, large 3DS, right? But even that, I think it's because I've got big hands. You've got to use the shoulder buttons as well, the stylus to aim, and you're like this, and you're trying to get it in 3D, because I've got the old 3DS, not the new one. So you go out of 3D quite a lot, and it just becomes awkward. The whole gameplay becomes really awkward and uncomfortable, and I had to put it down, which is really unfortunate, because I really did like this game. So maybe it's just me, maybe it's because I've got big hands, I've got really big builder's hands, guys. If you've got smaller hands, maybe it won't affect you in the same way. So I definitely recommend picking it up. I think you can get it quite cheap. I don't think it's that expensive. But yeah, I'll definitely give it a go, guys. You know what? If they bring out this new NX, this new Nintendo console, and you can play handheld games on the big screen, like you used to with the Game Boy Advance, the Game Boy Player, you know, you plug that into the Super Nintendo and you get the little Game Boy game come up the screen. I would love if they could do that with a 3DS. Now, games like this on the big screen would be awesome. let's just hope, guys, that happens. Another DS game I've been playing. This is a really cool game. It's a DS exclusive. It's Metal Slug 7. This is my American cart. It comes with a wooden sleeve. Okay. So it's a nice game for you Metal Slug fans. If you like Metal, I know there's a lot of Metal Slug fans out there, because I know they pay a lot of money for the MVS or AES carts. Some amazing box art, guys, look at that. And it's a cool little game, you know, it's a fantastic little game, but this is sort of the era that I got out of arcades, right? This is the coin munching era, where you had loads of continues. A lot of these side-scrolling brawlers had them, where the company, the game company, wanted as much money out of you as possible. So they deliberately made certain parts of the game hard, so you have to put more coins in. And if you don't mind that, if you don't mind keep continuing, then these games are great. But I'm from that era where, you know, it was all down to your skill whether or not you got further in the game. And I'm not really cussing these games, I do like them, but there is a difference, right? The early classic arcade era was an era of where you had to have skill to progress, whereas later 90s games, you had to have money to progress because of the continue factor. So, but if you don't mind that, it's a good game. I'm really enjoying it. I've got to about stage 7 or 8 and I'm really enjoying it. I've got to mention this, Smash Brothers, playing it on the 3DS and the Wii U. They've just added more characters, Cloud being one of them from Final Fantasy, awesome character, and have announced they're going to release Bayonetta, which is fantastic because I'm a massive Bayonetta fan. I love that game. And this game just gets better and better, really. Now, you know, it's an odd game mechanic, and I know it's not to everybody's taste. You know, you can't compare it with games like Street Fighter. It's like trying to compare Mario Kart with Forza. They're two completely different games. So treat this game not as a fighter, but just as a fun-ass game to play, right? Because it is. It's really, really cool. And I can't get enough of it. My next two games are Super Nintendo games. And let's start with this one, actually. Knights of the Round, which was a game I got off Retro Dave, part of our little exchange we did. This is, I would say, just about above average game. I'm enjoying it, and the reason why I'm enjoying it is because the music is carrying me through the game. The music to this game is really, really good. I'm really enjoying the music. It's not a bad game. I mean, the game mechanics is all really cool. I just think it lacks variety, and a lot of the enemies are very similar. You know, you get some tigers come out at you one level, and then the next level they're a different color. You know, come on, throw something else at me. I just thought that was a bit cheap. But other than that, I'm really enjoying this game, and I got to about stage 6. I got quite far in it, again with lots of continues, but I did enjoy it. We'll stay in the collection this game, as I do like this kind of genre of gameplay. It's cool. I do like it. The next game, again, is another side-scrolling brawler, which this game is awful. And I kind of knew it was going to be, but going on the arcade version, which is unbelievable. This is when side-scrolling brawlers are fantastic. Alien vs. Predator, the arcade version is unbelievable. If you haven't played it, guys, download it on MAME. Just go out there and play it. If you've got an Xbox with coin-ups, that's my cat trying to get in, you've got to play the arcade version, not this version. This is awful. This game, there's nothing about this game that's good at all. It doesn't resemble anything of the arcade version. It's a terrible port. The sprites feel like they're on a stick, you know, like in a puppet show, and someone's kind of putting them in from the edge of the screen. It feels like that. They're so wooden and stiff. It's just awful. The animation is so stiff and wooden. Lots of cheap deaths as well, with the face huggers jumping out of your face. Couldn't escape them. I had to keep doing my special move, and of course, every time you do a special move, your health goes down. So I had to keep continuing to get past the face huggers. And in the end, I got fed up with it and put it down. The sound is awful. The sound of the aliens sounds like a dying cat or something. Absolutely awful. An expensive game to own. Don't recommend this, so I'll probably be moving this one on. Not a great game. Got to let the cat in. Hang on. She's meowing. I don't know if you can hear her. There she is. Right, so yeah, don't recommend that at all, guys. Not a good game at all. And she's all wet. You're all wet, cat, aren't you? Right, the next... we're going to pickups now, right? Pickups, my next pickup is a game that's playing on in... Oh, you're all wet. Come on, I've got to get this cat out. Hang on. She can stay out. She's soaking wet. Gonna jump on all my games and get them wet. Right, sorry, sorry guys. Right, my next game, this is a game I picked up right off eBay. It's playing on in the background. Don't know if you can see there because the light's a bit bright. This is a little game I found in Retro Gamer, actually, a little review of it. And I thought, well, that sounds quite cool. Never heard of this game before. And it's called Battlecross. It's got some funky box art. Look at that. Loads of colour clash going on there. But it's, I quite like the box art. It's a bit funky. Some screenshots on the back. And as you can see from the screenshots, you can see what type of game it is. It plays very similar to Championship Sprint. Or Rock and Roll Racing. So it's a top-down view of the track. It's multiplayer, up to four players, and you race around the track on these little motorcycles with no wheels. They're kind of like hover bikes that go around. You've got like power-ups as you go around, so you can get guns, shoot, oil slicks, whatever. You name it, it's in the game. And also the track throws up obstacles. You've got like a ship, a pirate themed track where there's a pirate ship firing cannons at you. As you go around, you've got to make sure you avoid those. It's a really fun, good party game. I can't recommend this. And I will do a little gameplay at the end because you've got to see this game, guys. Battlecross. Now, I mentioned this to my mate Dave about this game, and I actually had a bid on eBay. And it was quite funny because he started bidding against me. And the game went up to about 45 quid. And I said, I can't believe that, 45 quid. And then the next day he texted me, he said, oh, I bought that game. I said, really, did you? He said, yeah. I said, you didn't buy that one for 45 quid? He said, yeah. I said, Dave, I was bidding against you on that. Next time, let me know, right? This was after I mentioned it to him. But the funny thing is, I waited about a month for the next one to pop up. This one popped up. Okay, the box is a little bit crushed. It's got a crease down the middle here, right? But it's all there, the instructions there. I paid, you believe this, £14 delivered from Japan for a complete in-box Battlecross. So deals are out there, guys. If you're prepared to be patient, deals are out there waiting to be found, okay? And I know, if I hadn't mentioned that today, that I could have got that game for a lot less, because it was only me and him bidding against each other. So Dave, next time, let me know what you're bidding on. But yeah, this is a really fun little game. We'll have a little gameplay of that later. Picked up a little amiibo. Nearly finished my Smash Brothers to date amiibo lineup. This is Green Ninja. Like the stance, very stealth-like in appearance. Another really cool amiibo. Can't wait to get my amiibo all set up on the shelf up here. It's going to look really, really cool. I think I'm missing Falco now. And of course, the ones that haven't released, Bayonetta and whatnot, which are coming out in February, I think, or April. Also, my other pickup is a lovely Zelda calendar from my stepson, Morgan. Thank you very much for this, mate. Really, really love this. It's going to go up my Warner Games room. It's got some lovely artwork of Zelda in here, and of Wind Waker, and love Wind Waker art. Look at that, isn't that cool? Not sure if is that Oricano of Time or Majora's Mask. Phantom Hourglass. So some really nice artwork in there. Shows it all on the back, what you get. Yeah, so I mean, Zelda, along with Metroid, is probably one of my favourite Nintendo games. Just one of those games I can go back to. As soon as they released the HD version, I went back and played it all over again. My daughter absolutely loved it. It's one of those games I will always go back to. Fantastic game. Another little game I picked up here. This is a cool little Game Boy game, Rampart. Look at the box art on that, guys. Now, this was an arcade game. I think it was by Atari. Came out in the early 90s. must have came out after Tetris, because it's very similar gameplay to Tetris, but it's a little bit more strategic, because you've got like a top-down view of a land, and you own sort of part of that land, and it's divided by the sea, and you're getting attacked by ships with cannons, and they fire at your fortress, your castle. If they hit the walls, they get destroyed, and then the game in the next turn gives you walls to repair the walls that are damaged, but they're all different shapes, and you've got a time limit to fill the missing parts of the walls with these shapes that they give you. So it's a bit of a puzzle strategic game, strategy game. I really like it. It's excellent two-player, because obviously one of you can be the ships at sea and one can be defending. It's a really good two-player game. I've actually got it on a Super Nintendo as well. It's a good Super Nintendo game, very true to arcade version. I actually played this with a mouse. There you can see the graphics on the back. Very simple graphics, nothing special, but the gameplay is very cool, very addictive, very simple gameplay, and normally they're the best, aren't they? Especially with two player. So yeah, it's a really good game. Very arcadey, very cool. So nice to have that in the collection. That's Rampart. I do like the Japanese artwork on these games. And they're very small and dinky, you know, fit nice on the shelf. So that's it on the pickups, guys. Just gonna have a little break now, have a cup of tea. Throat's a little bit dry, and I'll be back in a minute with some shout outs. And what else we got? Oh, we're gonna go straight to the gameplay then. I'll just be back in a minute, guys. A couple of hours later, guys, I've grabbed myself a beer. Happy New Year to everyone. Now, I just want to say a few shout outs to some American collectors that invited me on their YouTube channel stroke podcast. I think it is becoming a podcast. It's not there yet, but it will be. It's called the Arcade Road Trip. And basically invited me on. I had to get up at 3 o'clock in the morning, because obviously the American time zone's different over there. But that's okay. I didn't mind. I was really excited about going on, because I follow a lot of these guys on YouTube. I know Adam does stuff with John's Arcade, and I know all the names because I've seen them at events in America, and I was really excited about going on there, chatting about my games and whatnot. So I just want to say thank you to Adam and Brad Orange Whip for inviting me on there. I really enjoyed getting up at 3 o'clock in the morning, believe it or not, and just chatting to you guys. It was great fun. Also, I wanted to say thank you to Paul from the Maximum Power Up for mentioning me on the 10 Pence Arcade podcast. Paul, thanks very much. Paul's a great guy. He does a podcast with Phil called the Maximum Power Ups. Really cool, covers everything from arcade, retro console, right up to modern day stuff. It's a really good podcast, totally recommend it. Paul, bless him, is trying to find these top 100 SNES games that Superplay was a magazine in the UK. It's a really good magazine, and towards its dying days it did a top 100 editor's choice of the favorite SNES games, and he's trying to get every single one. I think he's got about 23 left to get or something like that. And it's quite interesting, quite funny following him on his quest for all these games. It's really, really good, actually. And he does a little update every week on the podcast. So check that out, the Maximum Power Up podcast. And my next big... I won't do that yet. I'll do ETN. I think it's ETN. Hope I've got your name right, mate. Just want to say thank you for the Space Firebird control panel overlay. I really appreciate it. It's a fantastic job. It looks amazing on my machine. And I saw your Sheriff decal video. That looks like it's coming on really well. He's a great guy. He does all the artwork. He's done artwork for John's Arcade. He's doing artwork for Dean Leslie at the moment. His skills are extraordinary. Really, really good. Also want to say thank you to Ollie Muddy Music, obviously, for doing the Sky Skipper. He knows how grateful I am for him doing all of that. That's ongoing, obviously. And last of all, my big shout out to Ben Foster Purity for sorting out my balloon fight, which is the game I'm going to talk about and we're going to see in a minute. Ben basically put me on to the guy that was selling these PPUs in America. Now, with the Versus system, it's not the actual game, the ROMs that are rare, because obviously you can download the ROMs, the information off of MAME onto the ROM if you've got a burner. It's the PPUs. These are picture processing units. They're like little chips on the board They run the game. Without that, the game won't run. These are the things that are really, really rare. And Balloon Fight has its own PPUs, and they're really rare and hard to get hold of. And basically, he saw them up for sale on Clove, which is an American forum for arcade collectors. And he basically buzzed me and said, Al, there's some PPUs for sale. And I brought them, got them back here, populated the motherboard, which is this here. This is the motherboard, and it didn't work. So I sent it off to Ben, who's got a Red 10. He's got a Versus system. He has one of the first guys to have a Red 10 in the UK. I think there's about 3 or 4 Red 10s now in the UK. He managed to fix it for me. So Ben, I really appreciate your hard work, mate. I really do. Thank you very much. So I just want to talk about this game now. So basically, you get your Versus board, which is this, right? And you slot it in the machine, which I'll show you in a minute. And basically, you can play two games on here because the Versus system has two screens. So you can have one game on one screen and a different game on the other. So normally, you'd have like Excite Bike on here and Super Mario Brothers on here. But with Balloon Fight, because it's multiplayer, it's two players, you can play on both screens simultaneously. You populate both sides of the motherboard with Balloon Fight ROMs. But also you need these are the PPUs, and these are the things that are really rare and hard to get hold of, and each game has its own. Well, some games use the same PPUs, but there's a couple that use their own, and Balloon Fight's one of them, and they're really hard to get hold of. So yeah, this is the Versus board. You can see it's got two connectors here for both sides of the monitor. One for each monitor, I should say. And there you see, there's the PPUs here. And these are the ROMs that hold all the information for the game, okay? So what I'm gonna do now, guys, I'm gonna set the camera up and I'll slot this in, and we're gonna do a little gameplay of Balloon Fight, because the reason why I wanna show you is you've probably got Balloon Fight at home on the NES, and you might have played it on the NES Remix on the Wii U or the NES Remix on the DS. And there are some other versions of it, which I'll show you in a bit later. But the reason why I'll show you this is because it is different. This came out in 1984, okay? It was a game made by, what's his name? I can't remember his name now. Satoru Iwata, who died last year. He was the president of Nintendo. This was the first game he ever made, right? And this is why it's very important, this game. It's quite an interesting game in Nintendo's history, because it's Satoru Iwata's first game he ever made. So let's take a look at this, guys. We'll set the camera up and we'll slot this game in, okay? Right, so this is the Nintendo Red 10. This is the Versus system, okay? So I've got my little daughter here, Isabella. Say hi, Isabella. She's going to play with me, okay? So we're going to be on she's going to be on one side and I'm going to be on the other, okay? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put the game in first. I'll show you how to put the game in the actual machine. Okay, so what I've got to do is lift the bonnet up. Okay, lift it up here. Can you see in there, guys? So I've got the game in there. Let me turn the light up a little bit so you can see a little bit better. Is that better? So that's the game in there I've got in a moment. I think that's Excite Bike and Super Mario Brothers. So we'll take that one out. Let's just set the camera up there. Undo these little connectors here. Okay, it's just like swapping an NES cart over. That slots out like that. Then I get my Balloon Fight PCB. And I slot that one in there like that. And it's that easy, guys. Put the connectors on. Down with the hood, and I should be able to fire this up, and Balloon Fight should come on. These are interchangeable. My good friend Muddy Music made these. He does all the artwork. That's really, really cool, because the original ones cost quite a lot of money to get hold of. So I've got Ollie to make those up, which is cool. So let's turn the machine on.
Is mine going to turn on?
Yours are going to turn on, darling. Yeah, you sit on that side. See, now we've got the game on, right? Oh, so yeah. I need to turn it down a bit so the guys can see this, okay?
Okay. Well, there are two guys watching us.
Loads of people watching. Right, so Yeah, we'll just play the game, me and Isabella, and I'll run you through the game as I'm playing it. Okay, so the basic premise of the game is to pop the opponent's balloons. Now you can work with each other or against each other, okay? You can work against each other for the highest points, or you can work with each other to get to the next level, okay?
With each other.
You want to work with each other. You want to work with Daddy, do you?
Yeah.
Okay, let's just set this camera up in a better position because I've got a light shine. That's better, I think. Let's just move it down a touch. Right, how's that? I think that's good. Let's turn the light down. Right, so when I say press number two, you have to press number two, okay?
Okay.
The button number two, okay? Ready? Go. Press number two. Right. Now, press the red button.
Okay.
Right, you're the blue man and I'm the red man, okay? So, as soon as I press the button, okay, I ascend upwards, okay, and if I let go, I descend, okay? And the base, it's a bit like Joust from, remember that game Joust from Williams? So I have to sort of hover around here and pop that guy's balloon, alright? And then his parachute comes open. Oh! I got eaten by the fish.
I can't fly.
Well, you have to keep pressing the button, darling. Like, really quickly, see? Then you go up.
Oh, yeah.
Alright, and then you have to pop my balloon. Oh, I popped yours.
How do I go forwards and backwards?
You have to use the joystick, left and right. So let me show you guys. Right, gosh, your pad two's over. Press number two, darling. Now look, see how it scrolls upwards vertically. Now the NES doesn't do that. Oh, you got me. So once you've got hit their balloon, the parachute comes open, and then you have to get them again for 1,000 points. And you can fly up again, keep going up, and then there's the roof. You hit the roof. So that's as high as it will go. You can also get these bubbles for extra points. Yes, Skill McBill.
You are.
I think so, yeah. I've got 8,750. Whoa. I love it when the little fish comes out at the bottom and eats you up. If you hover around too low at the bottom. Oh, we nearly got you. Fish got you.
Get me.
It got you, didn't it?
Yeah, got me.
Let's get that one.
Oh, nearly got me that time. I thought we were working in a team.
We are. Oh, you went into me. Right, level one done.
Okay. Level two.
Oh my god.
Oh my gosh, I keep going different ways. Stop!
Oh. Someone got eaten by a fish, was that you?
Yeah.
Right, press number two.
Wait, I'm the blue, aren't I?
You're the blue one, I'm the red balloon. So even though I'm at the top half of the screen, Isabella is on the bottom half. She's seeing the bottom half of the screen, you see. That's what makes this different from the NES. You wouldn't be able to do this on the NES.
I just keep falling.
And it makes for a great game, it really does. You get someone that's really competitive. It's so much fun, this game.
You know, I keep falling.
Oh. I know. Yes. Now you get a little bonus stage, look. You have to pop all the balloons. Now you do get this on the NES.
I'm just going to stand.
No, try and pop them all.
Yeah, that's...
Oh.
My flying is really bad.
That wasn't so good. I have actually managed to get all of those balloons in one go.
I cannot even get the balloons.
You didn't get one.
I only got two.
Oh,
seriously,
okay.
Look. I did
Okay, right, next stage.
Oh, is somebody
yes, Steel McBill. Oh my god. No, can't see a picture of them. She can't work it out. Come on.
I'm trying to get... Oh, got me.
Oh.
I keep running.
Oh. Love that little fish. Oh, look at that.
I don't know why I keep going up and then I keep falling down.
Oh, I think if you've got only one balloon, it is you ascend a lot or you descend a lot quicker. Oh, because obviously you've got less air. Yes. Get him, get him. He's in the water. Oh, did you die?
Yeah.
Oh, press two.
I think I... No, you died, I think.
No, I didn't. I didn't die. Not Skill McBeal, he never dies.
No, you did.
No, not Skill McBeal, never dies. Ooh!
Am I Skill McBeal?
You better kill some balloons first, knock some balloons out. Become Skill McBeal.
I'm so bad at this game. Oh. Are you watching me?
Got him. Have you got any yet?
No! Pressing it.
Right, we'll just get to the next bonus level. I just want to show you little wind turbines. These little things in that sort of turn around when you hit them and sort of spin you off in all sorts of directions. Oh, I'm trying to get this guy here. He's running away. He's down your end, Isabella. There's two down here.
Is he?
Oh, he got me. Yes. Oh, got you, sorry.
Oh,
press
Daddy.
Number two.
The blowing
yay, bubbles. We got him. Oh.
Hey! Are you trying to get me?
Trying to get that one there.
Push
sorry.
Me.
Oh! Flapping his arms about. Come on.
You know I'm actually losing, Kai. I don't know who.
One more to get. Come on. You're not playing. Oh! Yes. That's it. Right. Last bonus stage. That's it, guys. So that is Balloon Fight on the Versus system. Okay, Isabella, thank you very much for playing. Help me Daddy out with that.
Yeah,
there
you
go. There she
yeah.
is.
Wait, let me see you. What?
Okay. Yeah, I just noticed when I was filming that with Isabella, I had it on 60 frames per second and I should have had it on 30 to be in sync with the CRT. So unfortunately you've got those horrible black lines. I really apologise for that, guys, but you get the gist of it. It's a fantastic game. I'll just show you quickly, without the black lines, a quick game of me just playing it on my own. It's absolutely beautiful. And my monitors have got a lot of screen burn, but because this has got a black background, you don't notice it, which is great. It's a fantastic little game. I really love this game. And I loved it on the NES. But to play this version with someone else, another opponent, and it's scrolling vertically upwards, it just makes it, you know, a much deeper game. You know, I can scroll, you know, three times up the screen here. It's just absolutely awesome. You know, absolutely brilliant game. Well, I'm not going to show you a whole game that now because you've seen that side, and obviously I'm running out of time. And I want to just quickly show you the NES version. So let's have a look at that now. So this is the NES version, guys, and it says 1984. I thought this came out in 1986. I don't know why. So they must have come out the same year. But this is different than the, obviously, the arcade version, the one I just showed you, because it doesn't scroll vertically upwards. So let's just have a look at that. Just quickly show you here, look. That's it. So I reach the top here, and that's it. I'll stop. I can't go any further. So it's a very, it's a much smaller game arena to play around in than my Versus version. Still very cool though. I mean, I loved this game before I played the Versus. It's still very cool, two players. If you've got this on the NES, just dig it out, guys, and play it. It is really fun, two players. So you get that, you still got the little fish there that comes out. The lightning comes out of the clouds if you hang around too long. What else can I show you? Let's just die a minute because I want to show you another little game mode. So the only other thing that the NES version has over the Versus is the balloon trip, which is this. Now you might have seen this on the NES remix for the Wii U or 3DS, and basically you just got to get to the other side and collect as many balloons as you can whilst avoiding the lightning stars there, and it's just basically trying to beat your old score. It adds another different mode of gameplay to the cart, the package. It's quite cool. Ooh. So yeah, I really love this. Before I got the Versus, I was playing this all the time, and every time a mate come round, we'd play it, two player, it's excellent. You've got to play this, guys. Obviously, you're not going to be able to play the Versus version unless you've got main. You could probably fire it up in there, it would work. But yeah, check out the NES version, it's a really good game. So, I hope you enjoyed that video. unfortunately, I was really gutted after I filmed that with Isabella about the lines, but unfortunately, it's done, it's dusted. She had to go up to bed, that's it, I'm not doing another video, so unfortunately, but I think you get a gist of it, you could quite see what was going on there. It's a fantastic game. You could see how much fun me and her were having. I've had mates around here and we've had a right gas on it. It really is one of those games you can play over, like Mario Kart, you just play over and over again. It's a great party game. If you've got the NES version, just get it, guys, or dig it out and play. It's a lot of fun. Now, I just want to show you my other version of this game. I've got the Famicom version. Now, these are not cheap. Balloon Fight is not a cheap game. I paid £50 for this. It's quite a rare and hard to find game on the Famicom. But look at the box art, guys. Isn't that beautiful? I'm loving that. That is so cool. I really do love the in-house Nintendo games for the Famicom. They're really, really beautiful. And I love that. There is, of course, the Game & Watch version, which came on the crystal screen. I don't know if you got it. It's a blue crystal screen Game & Watch. And also did the widescreen Balloon Fight, I believe. Yeah, so there was two versions on the Game & Watch. I used to have the widescreen version, which is really good. So if you got that, there's another way of playing it on the Game & Watch, which is really cool. But this is really nice to have. And of course, This is the American cart. I don't have a box one because I go for a lot of money. I would like one. It's a black label game. I do intend to get it. But at the moment, I'm just making do with a loose cart of Balloon Fight. And it's just a free screws version. It's not the Mattel version. But still very, very cool. Again, they don't go cheap, guys. You probably pay about 30, 40 quid for a loose cart of Balloon Fight. But, oh my God, it's well worth it. Get rid of all those rubbish games you've got and just get one really cool game, because that is definitely worth having in the collection, guys. And the other version I want to mention, which is nearly as good as my Versus arcade version, and this is obtainable. It is quite a rare game. It's a Club Nintendo game. Can you guess what it is? It's actually Tingle's Balloon Fight. And this is a Club Nintendo, only came out in Japan, but this is really, really good. In fact, it's nearly as good, if not better, than the Versus game that I just showed you. And the reason being is because you can have local play, and I think you can play online. So if you've got a mate who's got this as well, two of you playing this on your 3DS or your DS, it's absolutely brilliant, and it scrolls even further. You've got the balloon trip as well. The graphics are all spiced up. Does look really, really nice, and I absolutely love playing this game. You'll probably have to import it from Japan, because Japan only Club Nintendo game, but I can't recommend this enough, guys. It's a lot of fun, and not as expensive as the NES version. Look, I think, can you see the screenshots? You get just of it, so it scrolls vertically upwards like the Versus game. And of course, you've got a nice sunset going on there. You've got day and night levels. And it's just a beautiful game. It's perfection. You can't knock the game. You either like it or you don't. But it's just one of those games that's just absolutely so much fun to play. So what can I say, guys? Just get out there and play some Balloon Fight. It is an awesome game. I hope I did it some justice. One of my favourite games by Nintendo. So yeah, that's it. That's the Balloon Fight vid. Now, I just wanted to show you before we go, I was going to show you this Battle Cross, which is, I think I showed you earlier. It's a Super Famicom game. It's a fun little party game. I'm just going to set the camera up here so you can see. We'll have a little go on this before we go, alright? Let's check this out. It's good fun. So here we are. This is Battle Cross for Super Famicom. Only got a Japanese release. I don't know why. It's an awesome little game. Get a multi-tap. Get a few mates around. This is a great, fun little game. It really is. So it's a bit like kind of like your championship sprint, stroke, rock and roll racing, stroke Bomberman type sort of party game. It's really cool. Graphics are really fun. It just does what it needs to do, you know. It's just a great little game. So I'm going to be the red driver. You can pick your tracks here. How many laps? Now, 15 laps might seem quite a lot, but it's not really, because the tracks are really small, really short. So let's pick something fairly easy. So you've got the two shoulder buttons. And one's brake, one's jump, one's fire. Because obviously you pick up items as you go around the track. You've got a brake button, accelerate, and I think a special weapon button. At the moment I'm doing pretty well. I'm the red guy. I don't go on the L and R because it... Oh, sugar. That basically reversed every command that I make. So if I want to go left, I go right. Don't go on that. Oh, watch the mines. Hit the mine. I don't know what blue blob does. So I don't know if I can jump over the corners. Can I? No, not quite. I'm not doing very well. what's that, 16 ton? Oh, get that weapon. Yep, got it. Oh, going the wrong way. Where am I going? Obviously, I've got a gun now, I can shoot. I don't know how long it lasts. Oh. So with my right shoulder button, I'm firing. I've got to get someone with it, come on. Oh, I'm going the wrong way now. Oh my God. Oh, over a mine. So anything can happen in this game. Obviously there's a lot of skill involved as well, and memorization of all the tracks helps. Oh, another mine. See, I've got him with a shot. I've slowed right down for some reason. Why is that? Ah, oh, where have I come? Six. God, not very good. That was quite a hard track, actually. Let's try a different track. It's very Japanesey, isn't it? I don't know what's going on there. It's like a pinball table, is it? Funhouse. Oh my God, I'm bouncing. Yeah, it's like a pinball table. Got the flippers there. Oh my God. This is just mad. Absolutely crazy. Oh yeah, I can shoot all of them. That's very satisfying. I'm the red guy shooting the little guy with the black helmet on at the moment. Oh, I'm bouncing off the walls. Oh, that jump actually helps. No, it didn't help there. I was trying to jump over those. Bloody hell, I'm going really fast. Blimey, that helped. I've got some weird power up that's actually taking control of my bike and moving me around the track. And I've got no control over my bike now at all. I don't know what's happening, but it seems to be working. Right, that's it, it's over now. I'm now back in control of my bike. This is weird. It's so much fun though. I mean, it'd be more fun with someone else, but it's still a lot of fun, single player. I can't get through there. That's really hard to get through there. I want another one of those power-ups. Oh, extra life, or some health, I don't know. Oh, come on! Can't get past those. Don't know, I was in the lead and now I'm doing really badly. Oh, watch the mine. Oh, I've got a fire, have I? I don't think I did very well at all. I was doing well. I came second. Hey, that's not bad. Don't mind that. We've got time for another course. What's that one? Simple one. Oh, by the sea. Again, I'm the one in the red helmet. I'm going to try and jump over that corner there. See if I can do that. Yes, it worked. Not quite that time. You can jump over the other players, but I don't think you can jump over that corner and cheat, which I was trying to do. Oh, I did that time. You just about jump over the the last bit of that island that's sticking out. Need some catching up. Oh, nice rocket I've got. Let's shoot the rocket. Yes, that's just like Mario Kart, isn't it? With the red shell, it's like a homing bullet, homing rocket. Ooh. Oh, hit the mine. This is so much fun. This would make a great arcade game. I don't know what happened there. Imagine it's the arcades with a steering wheel. Fantastic. I've got six laps to go, I think. I'm not doing so well. See, at the top there, the red square, it says six laps. I think that's me. Yeah, it's going down to five now. Yeah, I think I came last. Fifth, not bad. There you go, Battlecross is pretty cool. 15 quid, can't argue with that, guys. Battlecross, can't recommend this enough. Really fun game, really enjoyed playing it. And really lucky to get it for £15 delivered from Japan, can't believe it. But the manual as well is really nice and goes into real detail. Just a shame, obviously, it's in Japanese, but you can kind of make out some of the stuff in here. There's a lot of detail in here. Nice little screenshots of the track and all the icons listed and what everything does, which is nice. I do like that. Nice little backstories and all the little characters, which is really cute. All the power-ups listed. There's that weird one that I got that reversed every command that I put in. So if I went left, it went right. Mines, missiles, homing missiles. I don't know what that angel did or that fairy did, but she did something rather. All the tracks listed. So yeah, it's really nice to get a manual that detailed. They really put a lot of effort into the whole package. Really great game. Can't recommend that enough, guys. Well, that's it for this week. Hope you enjoyed the video. Sorry it took a while to get out, but hopefully the next one won't take so long. Thanks for watching, guys, as always. And if you want to catch me on my Facebook page, which is Ninty Arcade, or you can tweet me at Nintendo Arcade. Thanks for watching, guys.